Penguin Random House Canada presents The Strangers by Katherena Vermette. Read for you by Michaela Washburn. For my family. Indian girls can be forgotten so well they forget themselves. Therese Marie Myatt. Some stories are stories and some are just facts. Facts so important that story can't mess with them. Leanne Bedesimosike Simpson. Trigger warning. This book is about coping within the systems that have been imposed upon us, so there are plenty of triggers for those whose lives have been traumatically affected by them. These include depictions of child apprehension, solitary incarceration, suicide ideation, some drug use, and some physical violence. It's not just about that, hey? And I do try to cram as much love and hope in between as possible. Year 1. 1. Phoenix. The pain started in the middle of the night. Woke her up, that first one, like a fucking knife going right through her. She jolted up and almost made a noise. But then it went away as quick as it must have come. So Phoenix lay back down, rolled over on her side and tried to get comfortable again, tried to go back to sleep, but only ended up staring up at the top bunk, at the lump that pushed down on top of her. She hated being on the fucking bottom, always grabbed the top as soon as she could, but big as she was now, she couldn't get up and down without grunting or even falling, so she was stuck with the fucking bottom. That bitch Winona was on the top, snoring and rolling around. It felt like she could fall on Phoenix any fucking time, fall right on her gut and hurt her baby even. All Phoenix could do was turn over. She hated being stuck on the fucking bottom. On the other side of the room was another bunk with an old lady, Sue, on the bottom. The top was empty, for now. This was the infirmary cell. Women came and went, revolving fucking door. Phoenix had been here for days. Her due date was almost 2 fucking weeks ago. Any fucking time was all the bitch-ass nurse said when she checked on her every morning. Any fucking time. Like that was fucking helpful. Phoenix knew about Braxton Hicks or whatever they were called. She wasn't a fucking idiot. She'd had a few, like, strong cramps for months, so she didn't freak out at that first pain, even though it was different. Even though it felt like something different and scared the shit out of her. But she just rolled over again. Watched Sue sleep open-mouthed across the room. Every now and then, the old bag would cough so fucking deep and gross, sounded like her lungs would come up her throat. But old Sue wouldn't even wake up all the way. She'd only readjust her nose oxygen thing and go right back to sleep. Another pain came a bit after Sue's next coughing fit. That's how Phoenix tracked them. She knew to fucking track them and gauge them on Sue's coughing and how bad they were. In between, she tried to breathe like the book had told her, like the nurse had told her. It didn't fucking help much. Hurt like hell. And it was only getting started. It would be over soon. That's what they told her. Soon it'd be fucking over. Like that was a good thing. Phoenix thought of everything those first few hours. She tried to distract herself with anything she could think of. The brown house, Grandma Margaret's pancakes, Grandmare's fry bread, sitting in the old lady's lap listening to her stories. Her English broken by French words, Machif words, words Phoenix didn't always know, but somehow it didn't really matter. She got stuck for a while on her uncle's music. That was always her favorite thing to think of when she needed to think of something. Trying to remember the words to old Steppenwolf or Aerosmith songs. She mostly only knew the choruses, but she kept them going. Dream on became a chant with the pain. She didn't realize she was making any noise until Sue woke up. The light out of the small gap of a window getting brighter with morning. And the old lady still blurry across the concrete floor.
What's going on with you?
The old lady sat up with a choking sound that brought up another wave of cough and spit.
Is it your time?
It took her a while to say. Phoenix just lay there, breathing.
How long you been hurting?
I don't know,
she managed. Sue leaned forward to look better.
Guard!
She tried to yell, but only coughed again.
Get up and press, Winona, the button,
she choked as she called.
Fuck,
Winona's voice mid-snore.
She's getting her pains! Press the button!
Sue's hand to her chest like her lungs would fall out right there.
My word! You preggles will be the death of me! Guard!
The metal coils screeched as Winona got up and climbed down.
Why are you fucking yelling? They can't fucking hear you!
She pounded on the button and the light came on right away. The glare hit Phoenix's eyes like a hammer.
Finally! Fuck, hey?
Phoenix didn't say anything. Just breathed. Felt like the pain was all the time now. Her body fucking wrecked with it. Waves and waves on top of each other.
Can you sit up? They're gonna come in and check on you.
Winona was about 40, skinny as shit. She puffed up every couple days before she went to dialysis, but came back looking deflated and even skinnier. She looked super skinny now. She had a shunt in her arm and she was so thin, it stuck out of her sleeve. A plastic tube like a big open straw. It grossed Phoenix out all the time. Made her want to puke now. She looked away and tried to sit up, but her whole middle was like a brick, hard and pushing down. Felt like the baby was going to fall out right there. She finally managed to get her feet on the cold floor. The shock of it went right through her. She didn't want to stand up, though. The door finally fucking buzzed open.
Is this what I think it is?
Fucking Henrietta was guard tonight. Fuck. Phoenix hated that one. Always looking at her too long. Fucking creep.
You gotta take her, Henrietta.
Sue's voice was always somewhere between a whine and something even more annoying.
I gotta get my sleep or else I'm going to just feel so bad all day.
You're all hurt, Sue.
Henrietta's hands on her belt, thumbs hooked off it like she was relaxed. Phoenix knew better. She knew this chick was always fucking ready. Usually Phoenix was too, but right now she was only pain. And at this bitch's fucking mercy.
How you feeling, Phoenix? How long has it been?
A few hours, Phoenix panted.
Are they close? Getting closer?
Phoenix nodded.
Get her out! Sue shouted. Get her out of here! It's only like 5 in the morning!
Shut up, Sue,
Winona yelled.
I'll call it in, Phoenix, but the nurse will want to check you first. She doesn't get in till 7.
7? She's got to stay here till 7?
You know how this works, Sue.
That's 2 hours! You took that last one in, like, right away.
That was her 6th kid. She could have sneezed that one out.
Henrietta faked a laugh.
Phoenix is overdue, and it's her first. It's going to be a long one.
She turned to go out.
You don't know that!
Sue called after her as the door clanged shut.
She doesn't know that, does she? Winona! How the fuck do I fucking know?
Winona looked down at Phoenix.
How, like, far apart are they?
I don't fucking know. Phoenix wanted to scream, but she had no breath.
Okay, Sue, give me your clock. That's mine! You're going to break it!
The old lady's whining was really getting on Phoenix's last fucking nerve. She wanted to fucking tell her so, but she couldn't find the words. And then another fucking pain started. Her whole body tensed up like she was trying to fight it, but couldn't.
You better give it back as soon as they take her!
Winona grabbed the little clock from Sue's outstretched hand. It was only a small old alarm, the kind that ticked loud and could fold up into its little case. Sue kept it under her pillow, but Phoenix could still fucking hear the tick-tick-ticking. It was annoying as hell the first couple nights, until she got used to it.
Okay, let me know when the next one comes and I'll time it. We didn't have to do this with the other one!
Sue's whine reached a whole new pitch.
She knew what she was fucking doing. Does this one look like she knows what she's fucking doing?
Fuck. Fuck. Phoenix started. I know. Winona rubbed Phoenix's leg like it was something she had seen on TV. Something she thought she should do, but didn't really want to.
It'll be okay. I was with all my sisters for most of theirs. It's all okay in the end. Just can be long. Can you get them to turn the lights off at least?
Fucking Sue.
How am I going to tell the fucking time then? It's almost light out, Sue said. Oh, no. I'm going to be so sore all day now.
She started coughing again like she remembered she needed to be even more annoying. Winona settled in cross-legged on the floor with the clock in her hand.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.